الحمد لله، نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونتوب إليه، ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا. من يهد الله فهو المهتدي، ومن يضلل فلن تجد له وليا مرشدا. وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله. اللهم صل وبارك على عبدك ورسولك محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. Praise be to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We praise Him, we seek help from Him, we ask forgiveness from Him, we seek refuge in Him from our own evils and our own bad deeds. Anyone who has been guided by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is indeed guided. And anyone who has been misguided, you will never find a guardian to guide him. Bear witness that there is no deity except Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala alone, without any partner. And they bear witness that Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, the servant and messenger. O Allah, let your prayer, your peace, and blessing be upon your servant Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and his family and all his companions. In continuation of the seerah of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam's ethic, we're still with the ethic of al-istighfar, seeking forgiveness from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And we're still with the verses that about al-istighfar, and this khutbah, inshallah, we're going to address that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala ordering us to make istighfar. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala commanding us to make istighfar all the time for our benefits, to keep making istighfar all the time, because the benefits is unlimited when you make istighfar. Not only Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will forgive your sins, but also will give you more provisions, will give you prosperities, will just change your life. And Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam used to make istighfar more than 70 times a day. In Surah Al-Baqarah, verse 199, ثم أفيدوا من حيث بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم ثم أفيدوا من حيث أفاض الناس واستغفروا الله إن الله غفور رحيم. This when during the Hajj pilgrimage, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is given the order where you can, what you're going to do during the Hajj, and asking the people to move to where the people moved in sequence of the Hajj rituals. وَاسْتَغْفِرُوا اللَّهَ إِنَّ اللَّهَ غَفُورٌ رَحِيمٌ. And make istighfar all the time. Seek forgiveness from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Indeed, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the most forgiving and the most merciful. Also in Surah Al-Imran, verse 133 to 134, وَسَارِعُوا بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم وَسَارِعُوا إِلَى مَغْفِرَةٍ مِّن رَبِّكُمْ وَجَنَّةٍ عَرْضُهَا السَّمَاوَاتُ وَالْأَرْضُ أُعِدَّتْ لِلْمُتَّقِينَ الَّذِينَ يُنْفِقُونَ فِي السَّرَّاءِ وَالضَّرَّاءِ وَالْكَاظِمِينَ الْغَيْظَ والعافين عن الناس والله يحب المحسنين. وسارعوا, rush, quick to make استغفار إلى مغفرة من ربكم. This is something that you shouldn't just take it easy. No, be in rush, be quick, do it quickly, do it continuously to make استغفار. Because why you making استغفار? Because out of this istighfar, the Jannah, the paradise, which is, it's with the heavens, all the heavens, seven heavens, and the earth, was ready for the believers, was ready for the people who fear Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And what's the qualification of these people that are going to get this paradise with that size? الذين ينفقون في السراء والضراء, the people who spend silently or openly, the people who give charities, والكاظمين الغيظ, and if you are in a situation that you hold your anger, don't be angry. When you get to be angry, just remember Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. والكاظمين الغيظ والعافين عن الناس, and the people who forgive the people who forgive people. If somebody did something wrong to you, if you forgive him for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, wallahu yuhibbul muhsinin. Wallahu yuhibbul muhsinin. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala loves the people who give, the people who is generous, the people who is muhsin. Muhsin did mean that he generously give to others. There was an incident happened that one time there was a servant or a slave girl was putting water into for someone, her master, and then looks like that either the water was hot or messed up in the way that she was dealing with him. Then he looked at her and she was afraid, but she said, وَالْقَاذِمِينَ الْغَيْضِ. And الْقَاذِمِينَ الْغَيْضِ, he said, I hold my anger. And وَالْعَافِينَ عَنِ النَّاسِ, and I forgive you. When she told him how she faced him with that, when she did something wrong, وَالْقَاذِمِينَ الْغَيْضِ, then he told her, I hold my anger, and وَالْعَافِينَ عَنِ النَّاسِ, I forgive you. وَاللَّهُ يُحِبُّ الْمُحْسِنِينَ, and I set you free. So a situation like that, see, that's how the girl did that, and she freed herself with this one verse. وَالْقَاذِمِينَ الْغَيْضِ وَالْعَافِينَ عَنِ النَّاسِ وَاللَّهُ يُحِبُّ الْمُحْسِنِينَ. She was set free because of whatever she did, whatever she said to her master after that. In another Surah An-Nisa, verse 105-106, إِنَّا أَنْزَلْنَا إِلَيْكَ الْكِتَابَ بِالْحَقِّ لِتَحْكُمْ بَيْنَ النَّاسِ بِمَا أَرَاكَ اللَّهُ وَلَا تَكُنْ لِلْخَائِنِينَ خَصِيمًا وَاسْتَغْفِرُ اللَّهِ إِنَّ اللَّهَ كَانَ غَفُورًا رَحِيمًا. إِنَّا أَنْزَلْنَا إِلَيْكَ الْكِتَابَ, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala indeed is the one who sent that Quran for you with the truthfulness so you can judge between people. This means that the Quran is the way to follow, is the way to look any, if you are in any situation, look for the look in it in the Quran al-Kareem. Bima araka Allah wala takun lil khaineen khaseema, and don't be used as advocate to the people who betrayed you. So be careful when you deal with people. Wastaghfir Allah, and seek forgiveness from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Inna Allahu ghafuran rahima, indeed Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the most forgiven and the most merciful. Also in Surah Al-Ma'idah, verse 73 and 74, لَقَدْ كَفَرَ الَّذِينَ قَالُوا إِنَّ اللَّهَ ثَالِثُ ثَلَاثَةٌ وَمَا مِنْ إِلَهٍ إِلَّا اللَّهُ وَاحِدٌ وَإِنْ لَمْ يَنْتَهُوا عَمَّا يَقُولُونَ لَيَمَسَّنَّ الَّذِينَ كَفَرُوا مِنْهُمْ عَذَابٌ أَلِيمٌ أَفَلَا يَتُوبُونَ إِلَى اللَّهِ وَيَسْتَغْفِرُونَ وَاللَّهُ غَفُورٌ رَحِيمٌ. The people who said Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is one of three, they are disbelievers, and only Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, if they don't stop doing that, this is a severe punishment going to be on them. Shouldn't be better for them to repent for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for forgiveness? Wallahu ghafurun rahim, indeed Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the most forgiven and the most merciful. Also in Surah Ghafir, verse 53-55, وَلَقَدْ أَتَيْنَا مُوسَى الْهُدَى وَأَوْرَثْنَا بَنِي إِسْرَائِيلَ الْكِتَابَ هُدًى وَذِكْرَى لِأُولِي الْأَلْبَابِ فَاصْبِرْ إِنَّ وَعْدَ اللَّهِ حَقٌّ وَاسْتَغْفِرْ لِذَنْبِكَ وَسَبِّحْ بِحَمْدِ رَبِّكَ بِالْعَشِيِّ وَالْإِبْكَارِ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala guided Prophet Musa alayhi salam, and he gave the book to the Bani Israel. He has guidance, and also for them to remember the people who been guided before. And then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala asking, this is to prove for the what's Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam been through, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala asking him, "Fasbir, be patient. Indeed, the promise of Allah is truthfulness. Wastaghfir li dhanbik, and ask for forgiveness. Whatever situation you are in, always seek forgiveness from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and wasabbih bihamd rabbik, and always praise Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bil ashi wal ibkar, all the time in the morning and in the evening." So this is what you get used to, for ask for forgiveness from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in the morning and in the evening. And this means that in between too. So you always keep making istighfar all the time, in the morning and afternoon and the evening, as you walking, as you sitting, as you sleeping, as you whatever you do, always make istighfar. Astaghfirullah al-azim al-lazi la ilaha illa huwa al-hayy al-qayyum wa atubu ilayh. When you say this statement here, that whatever sin you have, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will forgive regardless. Because, and you keep insisting and you keep asking Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. When you ask and you insist, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is going to, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala like to persist and ask Him. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala love to ask Him. It's not like human that if you ask somebody for something, they will get angry after several requests. No, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala love for you to keep asking. And especially when you ask for what He asking you to ask, this is exactly what that will be the pleasure that you're going to have from following Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala commands. أقول قولي هذا أستغفر الله لي ولكم أدعو الله عز أن تكون هذه ساعة إجابة. Supplicate, may Allah accept our supplication at this time. Istighfar, this means that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala loves you. And the shaitan, the devil, hates you and may show things for you that you that may be sound good and surface, but in reality is to destroy you. But when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala asks you to do something, this is the righteous way. In Surah فصلت verse 6 بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم قل إنما أنا بشر مثلكم يوحى إلي إنما إلهكم إله واحد فاستقيموا إليه واستغفروه وويل للمشركين. الله برافت محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم الله سبحانه وتعالى asked برافت محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم to say I am a human like you, but Allah سبحانه وتعالى send the angel Jibreel to that indeed Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is your Lord and He is indeed the one, only one. So stay straight to His path and make istighfar, astaghfiru, wawaylun al-mushrikeen. The disbelievers, a great punishment awaiting them. In Surah Muhammad, verse 19, بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم فاعلم أنه لا إله إلا الله واستغفر لذنبك وللمؤمنين والمؤمنات والله يعلم متقلبكم ومثواكم. فاعلم أنه لا إله إلا الله. Indeed, know that there is no God except Allah سبحانه وتعالى. The oneness of Allah سبحانه وتعالى. This is what also your tongue should be repeating. لا إله إلا الله محمد رسول الله. لا إله إلا الله means affirm that for the oneness of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. واستغفر لذنبك. After you say La ilaha illallah, استغفر الله. Just to follow, just take an ayah and apply it. This is what the companions used to do. They memorize the Quran verse by verse and they don't move from one to one until they apply what they memorize. فعلم أنه لا إله إلا الله. Indeed, O Allah, I know that you are the only one. واستغفر لذنبك. O Allah, forgive me. Whether mu'minin or that, and when you make istighfar, when you do something good, generalize it to the Muslims, generalize it to the believers. Don't just make istighfar for yourself. No, make istighfar for you, for your family, for your parents, for your children, for you, for all the believers. Because when you do that, your rewards will be according to the numbers of the people that you make istighfar for. When you make istighfar for all Muslims, first of all, one time after a long time you're going to go underground and someone going to make istighfar for you too. So this is the blessing going to come to you. When you make istighfar for all Muslims, these Muslims, that will reach these Muslims. But you're going to, what's your reward? The angels waiting to respond to you and tell you, and for you, the themes, same. Then the angels, you're going to have immediate prayers from the angels. So always generalize your istighfar, generalize your dua to to all the believers, to all the Muslims. So you good reward according to the numbers of the Muslims that you make istighfar for. وَلِلْمُؤْمِنِينَ وَالْمُؤْمِنَاتِ They always make istighfar for the believers, believe in men and believe in women. وَاللَّهُ يَعْلَمُ تَقَلَّبَكُمْ وَمَثْوَاكُمْ Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala indeed knows where you're going and what's going to happen to you and what's your end, where you're going to end at. Now we'll end with this verses here. This is Surah Al-Muzzammil. That Surah Al-Muzzammil. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم إن ربك يعلم أنك تقوم أدنى من ثلثي الليل ونصفه وثلثه وطائفة من الذين معك والله يقدر الليل والنهار علم أن لن تحصوه فتاب عليكم فاقرأوا ما تيسر من القرآن علم أن سيكون منكم مرضى وآخرون يضربون في الأرض يبتغون من فضل الله وآخرون يقاتلون في سبيل الله فاقرأوا ما تيسر منه وأقيموا الصلاة وآتوا الزكاة وأقرضوا الله قرضا حسنا وما تقدموا لأنفسكم من خير تجدوه عند الله وخيرا وأعظم أجرا واستغفروا الله إن الله غفور رحيم. Now Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala indeed knows that you, addressing Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, that you wake up at night for two-thirds of it, or half of it, of a third of it, and other groups from the believers with you. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has the knowledge of the day and the night, and the عَلِمَ أَنْ لَنْ تُحْصُوهُ فَتَابَ عَلَيْكُمْ This means that you cannot do everything what is supposed to be done, but Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, do your best. Just always do your best. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, like for instance, when you, instead of, if you can't make prayer at night, just when you do the Isha on time, and you do the Fajr on time, and you, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala may make your reward that you have, the reward that you prayed all night. So you get used to such blessings from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, that when you recite, for instance, Surah Al-Ikhlas three times, قُلْ وَاللَّهُ أَحَدٍ, this you get the reward of reciting the whole Quran, and so on. So فَتَابَ عَلَيْكُمْ Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will repent on you, will have repentance on you. فَقْرَأُوا مَا تَيَسَّرَ مِنَ الْقُرْآنِ Just recite as مَا تَيَسَّرَ مِنَ الْقُرْآنِ whatever you can. Whatever you can, just the verses once in a while, or in the daytime, in the morning, in the evening, after every prayer. There is, especially now, it's very easy in your phone that you have. You can set it up to remind you to recite one page, two pages after every prayer. مَا تَيَسَّرَ مِنَ الْقُرْآنِ عَلِمًا سَيَكُونَ مِنْكُمْ مَرْضَى وَآخَرُونَ يَضْرِبُونَ فِي الْأَرْضِ Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala knows if you can't, you see, either you are sick or you are working, you work. But whatever you can, just do your best, and you, with your intention, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will reward you. يَبْتَغُونَ مِنْ فَضْلِ اللَّهِ وَآخَرُونَ يُقَاتِلُونَ Other people defending for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. فَقْرَأُوا مَا تَيَسَّرَ مِنْهُ Again, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala repeating, ordering us to recite the Quran. فَقْرَأُوا whatever you can, just recite. Even repeat reciting what you know. وَأَقِيمُوا الصَّلَاةَ Do your prayer on time. إِقَامَةَ الصَّلَاةَ Do it on time. What? And give your zakah and give it charities. Whatever you have advanced for yourself, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has the most rewarding. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the most generous. Whatever you give is going to be multiplied, unlimited, multiplied for you. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will have a great reward for you. And again, wastaghfiru Allah, inna Allah ghafurun rahim. Always seek forgiveness from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the most forgiving and the most merciful. أقول قولي هذا وأستغفر الله لي ولكم. أدعو الله عز وجل أن تكون هذه ساعة إجابة. O Allah, help us to purify ourselves in body, mind, heart and spirit. O Allah, do not let our heart deviate from the truth. Now that we have been guided, but grant us mercy from your very presence, for you are the grantor of bounties without measure. My Lord, help me to perfect my prayer, and of my descendants, our Lord, accept this prayer. My Lord, forgive me and my parents and all believers until the day of resurrections. Glory to Allah, Lord of majesty and honor, and peace be upon Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and his family and all his companions. Praise to Allah, Lord of all creations. أقول قولي هذا وأستغفر الله لي ولكم وأقم الصلاة.
الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله أشهد أن محمدا رسول الله حي للصلاة حي للفلاة قامت صلاة قامت صلاة الله أكبر الله أكبر لا إله إلا الله
الله أكبر
الله أكبر
بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم الحمد لله رب العالمين الرحمن الرحيم مالك يوم الدين إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين اهدنا الصراط المستقيم صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين
آمين
صلى لربك وانحر إن شانئك هو الأبتر الله أكبر
الله أكبر
سمع الله لمن حمده
ربنا لك الحمد
الله أكبر
الله أكبر
الله أكبر
الله أكبر
الله أكبر الله أكبر بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم الحمد لله رب العالمين الرحمن الرحيم مالك يوم الدين إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين اهدنا الصراط المستقيم صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين
آمين
بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم إذا جاء نصر الله والفتح ورأيت الناس يدخلون في دين الله أفواجا فسبح بحمد ربك واستغفر إنه كان توابا الله أكبر
الله أكبر ربنا لك الحمد
الله أكبر
الله أكبر
الله أكبر
الله أكبر
الله أكبر
الله أكبر
السلام عليكم ورحمة الله السلام عليكم ورحمة الله
السلام عليكم ورحمة الله السلام عليكم ورحمة الله استغفر الله استغفر الله استغفر الله السلام عليكم